Always giving new music first. The hottest artists first. Downloads free on iTunes, social interaction, and call in chat. We got you covered. Join the 365 Grind Radio Show movement today.
Whenever I'm around you, a river of love flows so deep. You must be angel sent, descended from above. It's truly a blessing, yeah, to have your precious love, to imagine life here without you would be impossible. You're
Radio at its best. You're listening and locked into 365 The Grind Radio with your man DJ DMV the Don.
I am music. Don't know what to say. Yeah.
shake my head in disbelief and smile. Never thought that this could happen to me. Oh, rest assured there'll be no complaining, you see.
This is 365 The Grind Radio Show. You know what it is, man. This is an exclusive interview with a special guest, Kanya Doss. And we did a feature of her early in the week, and I'm very proud of the feedback from a lot of you out there appreciating the music and also the feature of such a wonderful artist. She's a multi-award-winning soul R&B singer-songwriter. She's releasing her 7th studio album, which is called 7, and it was released on May 19th. Following the events, she also performed with Chrisette Michelle, Kendrick Family, Dwelle, Life Jennings, and a host of other accomplished artists. We're happy to have her on the show today, and we want to welcome her. Thank you for being our special guest exclusive interview today. Kanya Doss, taking out your time. How you doing, lady?
I'm good. No complaints at all.
Okay. Well, we're going to get right into this interview. Go ahead and talk to the people for those out there who haven't heard of you. You're very accomplished, called by many of your fans and lovers of your music as the queen of indie soul music. Talk to the people and let them know about who you are, and we're thankful to have you on the show today.
Well, thank you. You know, I've been doing this for a while, but I still feel like I have to... In order to live up to that title, I still have a lot of work to do. But I embrace it and I receive it, but I'm working towards that. I'm currently promoting the new Project 7, which is my seventh recording studio project, and I'm just enjoying the reception behind it. It's just, it always feels really great when it's received really well, because, you know, you're always kind of unconsciously competing with yourself with the previous project.
Okay. And with that being said, I want to just kind of throw a tidbit out there, because I got a lot of fans and family members and big supporters of the show. And when I told them that I was doing a feature with you, I'm always looking for artists and those who impact music on in a different way, meaning that like your music is like timeless. I remember I had a friend and we was having a conversation about some artists, you know, kind of in a conversation about artists you listen to and that you like, and your name came up, and I believe this was about maybe about five or six years ago, and your name came up, and I was surprised because I haven't really heard of you at that time.
Uh-huh.
And when she told me to go and listen to your first album and told me I'd be a fan, and she know how I like music and things like that, I'm trying to tell you the first couple of tracks of yours I heard, I've been a fan of yours ever since. And you know, I just want you to kind of speak to some of that, because a lot of your songs, like Don't Change, is like one of my favorite songs, just because the one, I mean, you have a lot of songs that are my favorite. And so for folks that have never heard of you and haven't seen you perform or anything like that, what would you say about you and your music? How would that music come across, and what do you have to offer for someone who haven't heard of you at all?
You know, I just think, like you said, and not to toot my own horn, but I'm my worst critic, probably, but you can go, I think 20 years from now, my music is still going to still have that feel good vibe. And, you know, I just think I'm an old soul. So I just think, you know, and I only hope, let me put it that way, that my music can continue to inspire and motivate and just create that feeling that the music I grew up on. You know, grew up listening to, like, the Stevie Wonder, Steely Dan, Donny Hathaway, etc. Because music is just, like, it's a gift. It's just amazing that, you know, music can impact others. And that's, I just do what I do, you know. And I just think that anybody that doesn't know my music, when they hear it, they'll know what we're talking about.
Okay.
And there's something for everybody. And it's just funny that you were mentioning those songs, because when I do live performances, I don't too many of those, and it's like, now I gotta start paying attention to the songs that are like the standout.
Okay. With that being said, can you share the story behind the story on your road to success and the hard work to get to the level where you at? And I know you're very accomplished, because there's a lot of artists that have been in the business for a while, and some that have have been noted as being very impactful artists with the way that their music is and the way that they have been able to get that across to their audience. Your music kind of captivates people, and I've always wondered, like, with your songs, are they personal experiences? Because, like, when I say those are my favorite songs, those songs have been important in certain periods of my life, like with me and my relationship with my wife, certain friends that I have, and I just want to know, like, going into the studio and making those songs, this ain't like they just touch people. You know, how's the mindset going in with making these songs that are timeless and that touch people? Your lyrics, just the way your voice kind of streams, it kind of leads people along. And then I love your choruses and how you break it down and get right into the song. It's like you give people something before the song ends.
Thank you. Wow. Wow, you just did it all. No, I'm just joking. You know, I think my heart, I have to take in from my experiences. I think life itself could be busy and complicated and wonderful, all those things. So I think everybody has to have some form of an outlet. And for me, you know, even when I get stressed out or whatever I'm going through, music is therapeutic for me. And I think, you know, I sing from the soul, from my heart, from the core of my soul. And I think that's reflected to my music, and I think that's what people are feeling. So they're feeling exactly what I'm feeling when I record during that time.
Okay. All right. And with that being said, thinking back to when you was a childhood, what was the type of music that kind of hit you and maybe played an impact in you being in the music business or wanting to be a music artist?
You know, I was blessed living in Cleveland, Ohio, just to grow up seeing LaVert, you know, with Gerald LaVert and Sean and Mark. We had a lot of talent here in Ohio, the Rude Boys, and, you know, Michael, listening to Michael Jackson and Stevie Wonder and Donny Hathaway, those songs, every song has something that triggers your emotions. And, you know, it just became intrinsic for me to kind of like mimic Michael's runs or Stevie's. And I didn't even, you know, being so young at the time, I didn't really know what it was, but I was like, wow, I can mimic it, and I feel it. It's like a feeling that you get that I can't even explain.
Okay.
And that's how that took place, and
What impact artist has played an important part in your career or even influenced you as well? You touched on that a little bit already.
It's so many, but Angela Winbush is one. You know, I think her voice is amazing, and just Nina Simone, just, you know, some people, you know, would say her voice is not pretty, but she was rough around the edges. It was just her soul, her lyrical content, her delivery. And, you know, it's a process even for me, coming from a performing school of art. I used to always try to make sure my wrists were perfect. And it's like, if you're thinking from the soul, you don't have time to think about those things. And that's what made me gravitate towards those artists. And a contemporary artist that I feel that does that is Mary J. Blige or Lauryn Hill. It's just diamond. They're just like, it's just raw, you know.
Okay. And have you ever, do you remember the first song that you sung, and how did you feel when you actually performed that song?
Oh my gosh. The first song was by the Pointers, which is, I think, I Need You. I don't know if you ever remember it.
Yeah, I remember that
you
song.
Can look it up. And it was funny because my confidence, and I was like a little toothpick. I think I was in sixth grade and they gave me that solo and I was shaking. I mean, literally, you could see me shaking. My hands are shaking, and it was just like, wow. But I thought I had did a horrible job. But after I finished, you know, all the teachers and students were just giving me a bunch of kudos. And I'm like, wow. You know, it's always good to get that extra confirmation that you're good at something. So I was like, okay. And that was just so surreal to me. At the same time, it was frightening. It was terrifying.
And do you still get, you know, that feeling when you perform, like right before you perform, do you still get nervous or you still get those feelings of, you know, going out and performing and feeling like, hey, you know, I want to do my best and how, you know, kind of getting a feel of how the audience receive you? Because I'm pretty sure after the first couple of songs, you kind of already have, you know, because your core fans will be singing like your songs probably word for word.
Right. You know, I do get that. What makes me get really nervous is I have to wait. If I can't go straight on stage, I get extremely jittery and nervous. It's like my stomach just starts to hurt. But then once I'm on stage, I just do it. It's like, woo! You know, you get that little shout out before you go on stage and just do it. But yeah, I still get nervous. And a clear indication of that is that if someone who knows my words verbatim, sometimes I'll forget my lyrics and I'm like, oh crap. And luckily, like you said, somebody in the audience will know if I'm watching their lips. I'm like, okay, let me get back on track.
Okay. And what can we expect from your live experiences as far as coming to see you? What kind of feedback have you been getting?
I'm always positive. And, you know, for me, I just even see growth in myself because a lot of times I was just so much more comfortable in the studio because I always wanted to initially do things behind the scenes. But, you know, now it's just the energy. When you get the positive energy from the audience, it's just reciprocated back and forth. And it's just so real, just so cool, and it's just fun. You know, the audience, I expect a lot of call and response, you know. Mm-hmm. It's just fun. That's what, you know, fun and soulful, and I have a message.
Do you
prefer all of my songs to be delivered.
Do you prefer the studio more than performing?
No, I can say it's a balance now. It's just, to me, I feel like I'm a crazy mad scientist in the studio when I'm doing vocals and laying things down, but It's like apples and oranges, and it's like when you create the music,
uh-huh.
Now you're able to deliver it, and then you're you know, feeding the souls of you know, you're just feeding the music to people's souls, and then just to get the positive vibes or when the energy is just really great, it's very rewarding. So I say they're both. I enjoy them both, and I'm just much more comfortable on the stage now than I was before, because definitely I was extremely comfortable in the studio. Now
who would you compare yourself to as far as an artist? It can be an artist back in the day, or artist that you feel like you kind of either patting yourself or a lot of people compare you to. Because when I hear you, I hear a little bit and kind of go with me with this. I hear the kind of Anita Baker-ish, meaning that, you know how Anita kind of, you know how Anita kind of, she gives you a little bit of the song in the beginning, and then she kind of gives you that little bit in the middle, and then before the song ends, she kind of, like, gives you that, you know, that feeling you get about the whole entire song that kind of, you know, it kind of makes you feel good after you finish hearing the song. Because I've been vibing to, I had Lila James on early in the week. And I was supposed to have Teedra Moses on. I'm not for sure if you're familiar with her.
Great choices.
And,
individual. I love it.
Right.
Love
so with you kicking the show off early in the week, it was like I've been vibing to y'all all week, because I kind of like, I listen to music like every day, and sometimes I listen to music for hours in a day. And then so as I'm listening to the show I did with you, I'm like saying to myself, wow, like if the interview would have went with that, it would have been like probably one of the best shows I did so far. But your music, like you listen to song after song after song, and I tell people, if they haven't heard of you, go and get your first album, because your first album is actually hard to find on some of the digital platforms, because I'm not for sure if it was released UK wise or did that have anything to do with it. But if you go back and look at your first album have like either 5 stars or like a very high rating, and it's hard to get those songs. And some of your songs on your first album is still as good as any other album that you ever did. So we're saying that.
Thank you.
Who would you compare yourself to? And then your vocals are just like an instrument, you know, heard with music. So, you know, who would you say you?
Wow.
Get that.
I won't compare myself, because I think we're all the best at being ourselves. However, I would like to love to be in the light of Nina Simone and Anita Baker. I mean, that was when she first came out with that project. Well, it wasn't her first project, but with Sweet Love and Been So Long. I wanted to have that same impact where every song, you know, everybody was a hit.
Okay.
You know, everybody was out. Yeah, just her bra. That's funny you mentioned that, because my mom was just like Anita Baker. But anyway. she does. It's Natalie Cole. I would love to be in the light with her. Mary J. Blige, Lauryn Hill, just people that the Jill Scott. I love that their music stings to my heart.
Okay.
And I would love to be in the same light as them, you know.
What are some of your favorite songs to perform? I'm pretty sure some of them kind of drive your fans crazy. Can you give us a couple of songs? Because I know some of the songs I noted. You said you really don't perform, and I think those are some songs that if you did perform, I'm pretty sure you'll get probably a crazy reception. But what are some of your favorite songs to perform when you're doing live shows?
It's funny that you mentioned Don't Change, because that's one of my favorite ones, and it's very well received. You Got Me, the most recent single, Reach Out, I love it. That's from the new project. It just transcends so much bigger when it's live. And the audience really gets into that, what I do.
I love that.
One song I got to go back and add is Never Be the Same, and Losing Game is a hot one. So it's just a lot, but those are the ones that I really just love when I perform it, because especially with Losing Game, because the audience, when I get to the, the vamp, keep on, they just, they're singing it too, and it's just sometimes you got to put in a little work on certain songs, and those songs, I don't have to, to kind of pull the audience in, but, it's a ton of songs I probably am missing, but those are the ones that are standing out right now.
Okay, I'm glad you said that, because we started the show off with Heaven. How is that song for you? Because I love that song right there, Heaven. And then we played Never Be the Same, Don't Change.
Oh, yeah.
Just Because. I'm glad you said What I Do, because that's actually playing in the background, along with You Got Me and The One. What type of connection would you say you have to your audience when you perform?
It's just, it's just telling my story or telling my experiences or what I witnessed, and it's just the whole key is being able to make sure that they envision, that they can visualize, what I'm saying, that it's conveyed appropriately the way that I need it to come across. And there's been some hiccups where it didn't, and then you learn, from experience.
What was your...
So it's just,
Go ahead.
No, I was just saying you learn from experience, and to me, the more you perform and you talk to your fans and just as you're telling me, that kind of helped me sharpen my craft. I'm like, okay, I need to go back and revisit my set list.
Mm-hmm. Do you have any special stories or tidbits you could share with us today that were kind of awesome experiences with you, that you experienced with either a fan or a music peer in the business?
Oh, yeah. It's just, when you get kudos from people that I listen to, and I'm like, wow, they know my music. A lot of the heavy people I perceive as heavy hitters. And, to get a little tweet from an Erykah Badu to say, hey, Songbird, Pretty Boys, I'm just like, wow, really? Because I'm just so, I have tunnel vision, so I really don't really care on that. I'm like, wow, they're taking note of that. It's not that I'm a name dropper. I don't like to do that. But things like that, when you're appreciated by people that you have listened to and admired over the years, is definitely rewarding. But more so when it comes to your supporters, people that know and appreciate your music. Just recently, I was in Dallas, Texas, and a little short, little Caucasian lady came out there by herself, Carolyn, that was her name.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just crazy because she knew all my songs. She stood out like a sore thumb. But she knew every word verbatim. And then after the show, she came over and she was like, I know all your songs. They helped me get through so much. And I just wish you were saying, Ain't Giving Up and Never Be the Same. And I'm like, those things are memorable and they hit me really hard.
Okay.
Such a positive way is motivating. So, things like that is just, it keeps me going. Because, sometimes music can go up and down.
Right.
And
what about some of the ups and downs that you can share as an artist and some of the struggles that you've had, being in this business? Some people think that you just come out and you have hits and you just keep going, and some people don't understand the struggle and the long journey in this business, man. It's hard out here with these record companies and then trying to be you.
Right. It is. It's a huge struggle, especially when you trust people to have the same vision if you have, and I've had experiences where it didn't go so well, and, you know, we had to part ways, friendships were severed, and, you know, I promised myself I'll be honest with people up front, because sometimes you don't want to hurt people's feelings, so you just kind of avoid it. But no, I learned how to surround myself with people who have the same vision as I have, and I can be honest about it. They can be honest with me, and we can be respectful if we don't agree and we're not going in the same direction, that we part ways, because I've had some stories where, you know, monies were missing, you know, just really, really bad situations took place, and you just learn from those things. And to me, those are things that are catalysts that keep me moving, you know, moving forward and pushing on.
Okay. And I know a lot of God is surrounded by you. I hear it. You say that when you perform. Can you talk about your biggest breakthrough and as an artist, and what do you feel like you still have to become as an artist, or haven't achieved as an artist yet?
My biggest breakthrough, I don't even look at it like that, because to me, every time I create a new project and I gain one more fan, that's a breakthrough for me. But, you know, ideally, I would love to, you know, make sure that more people know about Kanye West, who she is and what she's about. So I think I still have a lot of work to do, and I'll just continue to do that. But, you know, I don't get caught up in the glam and glamour too much. I'm very introverted, believe it or not. Okay. When I perform, it's totally different. So it's just, you know, I just think, you know, to get a Grammy would be great, you know, but that's not something that would validate me. I got a Soul Track Award, which to me holds the same value in my mind, you know, just to be received.
Right.
Because I think sometimes people get caught up in the wrong things and lose the essence of what, you know, the beauty of music and what it's supposed to be about. So I just think, you know, I'm just still pushing, and every time that I move up or that influence one more life, or, you know, gain another fan, as I mentioned, then I think that's a breakthrough for me.
Okay. I know myself, you know, a lot of times when you talk to people or you're in the business and, you know, people refer to certain artists, you know, for me, I love the artists like you, Eric Robeson, the Ryan Leslies, some folks that kind of go under the radar with their music. But once you start listening to them, you kind of get this, like, wow, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, why don't I either hear this artist more on the radio, or why don't, when you hear the circle of, what's the top female artist or top male artist? I know people liking you and Eric Robeson in the same sense, because I think y'all are two artists that are mostly slept on when it comes to, R&B, soul, neo soul.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Talk about that. Is it any frustration in that, or just the accolades you get? Because I know, like, I heard Erykah Badu talk about how she was so she couldn't wait to meet you to let you know how fond of your music she is. And then you had other artists like Anthony Hamilton and Chrisette Michelle, even Lela James talked about you. I mean, how is that? I mean, I know it probably isn't frustrating, but at the same time, don't you feel like you should be mentioned right up there with those artists?
Yeah, I think it would be great, you know, but it's like, we know who each other, everybody knows who everybody is. They know who we are. Our comrades know
right.
who we are. And, you know, if you get caught up in that, then you become bitter, and that creates negative vibes.
Okay.
You know, and then nothing good comes out of it. And we know, you know, of course. And then some of the greatest music that can outright all of us, those people will never hear them because of the nature of the beast, how it's set up. So it's just, you do what you can, and those who embrace us, we just, you know, continue to do what we do for the love of the music. Because once you start getting caught up, and I didn't get mine, I didn't get, you know, my notoriety. I look at people like Little Richard and James Brown, who still don't get the accolades I feel they deserve. So, you know, it's me, I'm just keeping it moving.
Okay. I'm very, very, yeah, very.
I'm honored that you said that. I didn't know, you know, we went out to have shows together, and I love her music, I love her soul. That's another individual, you know. was just raw, and it just hits you.
Yeah. Because I'm always on all of the social networks, so I'm following you, and I mean I'm following like all the artists, but there's some artists that are my favorite, and I'm not afraid to say that you are definitely an artist.
Thank
that
you.
I'm telling you, I have when I played your show, my wife she hears your music at times, but then when you kind of playing somebody music like back to back to back, when you kind of doing like a feature or you kind of vibing with that artist, and my wife was like, "Wow, that's Kanye Dawson." I was like, "Yeah, that's Kanye Dawson." Man, when she was saying that, you know, she seen how like I was vibing as I was doing the show, but I kind of get that all the time with you. I mean, even like I said, when I was listening to Teja Moses and Leda James, these are some artists that I believe sometimes, if you don't get into their catalog, like you the type of artist, I say somebody would need to get in your catalog, because once they get into your catalog, they're a fan for life. You know what I'm saying? So I would tell anybody to go back and start with your early CD and your early album, and then just go from there. You know what I'm saying? Like your growth, I hear it. You know what I'm saying? And then I see why.
Thank you.
I see why my friend was like, you need to listen to her. You know what I'm saying? It's and so like I said, I've been a fan ever since. And I just want to say, music is always changing in the world, and it's such has such a powerful impact on people emotionally and spiritually. And it
does for me, for sure. I'm a testimony of that. So you're hitting it right on.
Yeah. And with that being said, it doesn't matter if it's young or old. So with that being said, everybody wants to be a celebrity, and don't understand the stories and the things of the business behind the scenes. So with that being said, if you could give any advice to any young artists out there that aspire to be in the music business, what would you say to them?
Okay, now I say this time and time again, because it's true. Stay true to yourself, stay true to your craft, and you have to, become knowledgeable about the business. It's forever changing. And surround yourself around good people and people that share the same vision, because if you don't do that, it's not going to work. You have to be honest with yourself. So I think if you, internalize those things moving forward, you'll be fine.
Okay. All right. Well, I just want to say this. In closing, it's been such a joy to have you on the show. Do you have any update performances, new releases, anything as far as a tour, special projects coming up that you'd like to share with the listening audience out there?
I do. I'm currently looking into working. I'm hoping that the Christmas project will be done at least for 2016. Because I've been getting emails like, "You're going to do that?" So I'm working on that with my little team of producers, and I will be in, I think next month, no, in October, Virginia, then I'll be going overseas afterwards. And I'm just steady being on the grind. So look out for my new single, my next single to be released. Reach out. It's going to be an extra little twist. And now some other big things going on. I don't want to jinx them yet. So look out for those things coming out in about maybe a month or so.
Okay. All right. And make sure you stay in contact with me. I love
you. I will.
And if there's anything I could do as far as support, music wise, whatever, you performing in the DMV area, please connect with us. I would love to bring me and my wife out to come see you perform. And
okay.
And in closing, 365 The Grind Radio Show, myself, DJ DMV The Don, we would like to thank you for being a wonderful guest on the show. Please make sure you come back in the future. You're always welcome at any time. And if we wish you much success going forward, God bless.
Thank you.
And if you would like to share your social connections and website information and have any shout outs, would you be so kind? So, and we appreciate you for an awesome interview. And thank you again.
Thank you. Yeah, I would love to have people reach out to me on my Facebook page under Kanye Doss. I also would like for people to like my Kanye Doss fan page. I'm at Twitter under Kanye D. I'm on Instagram under Kanye Doss. And my website is www.kanyedoss.com. A shout out to my little boy Blue, to Miles Jordan, to Myron Ruffin, and all the wonderful people that know me.
Oh, we appreciate that.
Thank you so much.
Love you for coming on, being a guest, featuring you exclusively this morning. And if you get a chance, if I don't get in contact with your manager, check out the show that we did, because I'm pretty sure you'll love it, man. We put together a great show for you on Sunday, and it was something that I got great feedback from, and then also I've been listening to it, like it's in my iPod, so I've been listening to it like almost every day. Because
I like the podcast, and I want to share it on my social media.
Okay, I'll definitely send that out to make sure you get that information. But thank you so much for taking
time out
on a Sunday morning, which is a blessed day. We appreciate that, and thank you. And we wish you all the best in the world. And I look forward to seeing you down the line. I really do. I look forward to seeing you down the line. You take it easy.
You too. Take care.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye.
All right, baby. Kanye Dawes, man. Lovely interview, man. Appreciate her coming through and being a special guest on the show. And make sure you check this interview out. It's exclusive, baby. Spreaker.com, man. Browse and search for 365 The Grind Radio Show. Got more interviews just like this, man. You know, I don't mean the name drop, but I got to. You know what I'm saying? Kanye Dawes, hey, thank you. Appreciate it. Love you. Wish you the very best. So many other artists. Chrisette Michelle, Raheem Devine, Jay Holiday, Tweet. Who else I can name? Yo-Yo from back in the day. Big Daddy Kane. Big Tigger. We also had Leela James on the show as well. Tedra Moses will be on the show. Kendrick the Family Soul I interviewed. Hey, check out the website. Check out the Twitter and Instagram at DMV's Next Big Thing. And you'll see it's not a game, man. We dedicate our show to good music. And you always hear good music on the show, whether it's R&B, hip-hop, or mixtape music, man. We give you what you want, man. We know what people like to hear. They don't want to hear all that talk. They just want to hear good music. And that's what we do. So we're going to continue to bring you interviews just like Miss Kanye Dawes and other artists. And just check out our show page. We also on Facebook, 365 The Grind Radio Show, on YouTube as well. You can like and subscribe to us free on all of the top social networks. And again, we appreciate you stopping through. This has been an exclusive special right here, Kanye Dawes, 365 The Grind Radio Show, man. And guess what, man? We're going to take you out with a song that I tell you, man, is blissful when you hear it. And that's what we're going to do, man. We appreciate her taking her time out on a Sunday. We love her and wish her the best, man. Let's go. It's 365 The Grind Radio Show signing off. This is your man, the hottest in the game, DJ DMV the Don. This has been exclusive. Kanye Dawes, baby. Special, baby. We love her, man. Hey, you should love her, too. Make sure you go support her music. Her album 7 is out right now. Make sure you check that on all of the top digital platforms, iTunes, Amazon, as well, Spotify. She's all over the place. Make sure you support her as well. Follow her again on Twitter at Kanye D, and then also on Instagram at Kanye Dawes. Make sure you like her Facebook fan page at facebook.com/KanyeDawes. All right, we're gonna take you out with Heaven. All right, right here, man. Hey, great interview all the way around. If you miss any interview, goes into podcast form on Spreaker.com, iTunes, and it streams to YouTube, man. We thank you her for coming through, and I wish all of you out there, thank you for taking your time out. Shout-outs to Tracy, shout-outs to Sabrina, and shout-outs to Tika, man. I appreciate y'all always supporting the show. And, man, this is why I do it, man. I do it for great friends and family and people like Raheem Devine, who's a big supporter of the show. Hey, man, this should be your platform when it comes to music, man. Stop listening to all that bull on these other networks and media sites talking about they number one and they the best and they the hottest. We don't believe you, like Jay-Z used to say, baby. Listen to our show. We also got our app on both markets on the Apple Store. The App Store on Apple and in iTunes, and also on the Android Google Play Store. 365 The Grind. You'll see the Washington Monument logo up there with the red and black stars, baby. You can listen to us on the go in your car, at work, or on your favorite iPod and MP3 device as you work out and go where you go on the go, man. We should definitely be your choice and source for urban music worldwide, all right? We're going to take you out right here. This is Heaven featuring Zero, Kanye Dawes, baby. 365 The Grind Radio Show.
Wonderful is the feeling that I get whenever I'm around you. A river of love flows so deep. You must be angel sin. Descending from above, it's truly a blessing, yeah, to have your precious love, to imagine life here without you would be impossible. You're like the air I breathe,
in the game. DJ DMV the Don. You're getting ready to listen to the hottest sounds on 365 The Grind Radio Show and download on iTunes. It's DJ DMV the Don.
Stop listening to all that talk and tune into us. We everywhere, 365, the Grind Radio Show.
All right, babe, we thank you for stopping by, man. This has been an exclusive interview with Kanya Dawes, baby. If you missed anything, like I said, go to Spreaker.com right now. Browse and search for 365 The Grind Radio Show. Make sure you hit the subscribe button. And like I said, anytime we're on the air, whether it's the podcast or go off the air, you'll get a message sent to your email, whatever social network that you use, either Google Plus, Twitter, or Facebook. You'll get a message sent to either one of your social networks letting you know we just came on the air live streaming right now, or the show is in podcast form for you to listen to and share. And like I said, we're also on YouTube as well, iTunes as well, and all of the top social networks, man. We got it covered, man. So we appreciate you stopping by, spending your time on a Sunday, man. Great shows like this are always there. We got over 200 and some shows, man, close to 300 shows of nothing but great features, interviews, and special mixes. And we do New Music Monday, also Throwback Thursdays, and we got the Friday Lounge with a number of grown and sexy music with the R&B, a little bit of hip-hop twist in there for those songs that are pointing and straight to the point. We set the move with the Friday Lounge. And then also on Saturdays, man, we get it in with the Go-Go, which is the sound of the city, which the show is based out of. That's the DMV, D.C., Maryland, and Virginia. The show is worldwide. So for all those local radio stations, man, those radio stations that are nationally as well, we are worldwide, all right? We got a great selection of variety of music, new and old, or old school and new school, as some would say out there. But we cover everything, man. There's no shortness of selection of great music on the show. And I'm pretty sure if you listen to the show, subscribe to us on Spreaker.com, on iTunes, YouTube as well, you'll find out, man, that we got what you need. So stop listening to all that talk and tune in to us, baby. We're everywhere, 365 The Grind Radio Show. We're going to sign off, man. Great interview, awesome interview, and we appreciate Miss Kanya Dawes for coming through, and thank her as well. Y'all take it easy, and God bless.
Music.